Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video on Fusion 360. And in this video, we are going to see how we can create a tap. And a very interesting training because we are going to see different features of Fusion 360. Subscribe to this YouTube channel if you like the content, a lot of graphic design content, 3D modeling content, CAD, content. First link on the description, the complete course Fusion 360 is available. So if you want to master this version, the free version for personal use of Fusion 360, step by step with a course structure, this course will be perfect. It is on the first link on the description. You will see the models, the sessions, what you will be able to learn with this course. So let's start. One of the first things that I'm going to do is to, here I can define the origins like this. And something that I will do is to go directly here and I will create a first sketch on this area. So I can click here, create a sketch. After that, I will select my circle tools and just create first circle with a specific value. I'm going to zoom a little bit. And we will enter a value of 20 millimeters and finish the sketch. After that, I can zoom and create a first extrusion. So I can click here, extrude. I can press E and to create an extrusion. And after I will enter a value, let's just work with 20 millimeters. And I will validate. Something that I'm going to do is to click on create. We have the possibility here to add a thread. So when I click on thread, I select the face that I want, select, and I need to select this face just like this. If you want to see the real render, you need to activate model aid. And after you have different parameters, we are just going to keep isometric profile with a size of 20 millimeters. So it means this size and this designation and just validate just like that. Perfect. After that, I will click on this face and create sketch. Something that I will do is to use create and we will use a polygon tool, circumscribe polygon, start with first point on this area. And I will create something with 20 millimeters and six sides. And after that, I will finish my sketch, click here and click here, and I will create an extrusion just on this area. And thanks to that, I can obtain this render. I think I put 20 millimeter, but maybe it's a little too much, as you can see. So something that I can do is to come back. I'm going to come back, yes. Maybe we can reduce a little bit, click here, create a sketch. And I will create one more times a polygon, circumscribe polygons, and yeah, maybe 20 is too much. Maybe I can reduce for 16. Let's just try, or well, it's okay. I'm going to put 20. No, I think 16 will be better. I will reduce a little bit. Yeah, 16. And I will finish my sketch. Just click here and click here. Extrude, I can press E. And I will extrude on this direction. About the value of the extrusion, we will work with 10 millimeter. And I can click on new body just here. So after, the next step is to select this work plane, create a sketch, and we will use the line tools, create a line starting from this point. I will go on these directions. So what value we will enter? Here I think it's a little too much. I can enter a value of 80 millimeters, then go on these directions, and I can create a return with, for example, 20 millimeters. And I can just press escape. I will use the fillet tools, click here and click here, and we will enter a value for this fillet. The value that I will apply is here we have 20. I can increase a little bit for 40 millimeter. And I can just finish my sketch. Yes, just like that. So after that, I have a feature, an interesting feature, create. You can create a pipe directly from this path. So you need to select the path, as you can see, so this one, and you can directly create this type of element. Something that I can do is to, you can work with a section size, so it means you can increase the section size just on this area. I think we can put 20 millimeter also, just here. If I select my front view, I can take a glance. Here we have the return, yes, perfect. And just here you can activate a hollow if you need. Here we have a hollow and you have the section thickness. And I will reduce for 2 millimeter, for example, just like this. And after that, I will create a new body and just validate. And I will obtain this render. Something that I will do after is to create directly a sketch on this area, or I can create offset plane, maybe create circles. Yes, definitely I will create offset plane. So construct offset plane. I will click here. And on this face, I will drag and move on these directions. And I will drag and move with a value. Here we have 40, it's too much. I think 35 will be nice. So after to do this work, I will create a sketch. Create a sketch just here. I will just create a circle starting from this point. And the value that I will enter here, we have 24. I'm going to check if it is okay. Yes, 24 will be great. And I can finish my sketch, create an extrusions. I can go on this area. And yeah, something that I'm going to do is to click here, extrude. Can press E, go on this direction, but we need to create a new body. And on this new body direction, two sides, just like this. And you will understand after why I'm going to do this type of work. But I think I make something wrong. It's not exactly this that I want to do. So I make something wrong. I'm going to come back. And don't want to work like this. I will just come back here and create a sketch more on this work plane, as you can see. So just create a sketch just here. And in this area, I will snap around. I think here it will be great. And I will repeat the process with 24. And I will drag and move a little bit on the left, like this. Let's take a glance. Yes, it's okay. And I need to check something first. Yeah, maybe I can go a little bit on the right. Yeah, just here. And I will finish my sketch. So now what I'm going to do is to create an extrusion. So create, extrude, select here. And I will, here on the direction, select symmetric, but I will create a new body. And about the value of the extrusion, I can select my front view just on this area. And I can define a value here of 14. I think it's too much. We can define 12. And create a new body. So after that, I will click here and create a sketch. I will define another circle, a little bit smaller, just like this, with, for example, 20 millimeter. Finish the sketch, click here, create a small extrusion, just like this, maybe with 2 millimeter. And I can create a new body again. I will click here, create a sketch one more times, and create another circle, a little bit smaller one more times, with, for example, 8 millimeter. Finish the sketch, click here, extrude. I will extrude with a value of 2, new body. And I will repeat the process, click here, create a sketch, and create another circle one more times, this time with a value of, here, just 4. Yeah, I think I can work with 6, just here. Finish the sketch, and create another extrusion. So here I will create another extrusion. Let's apply, yes, I think 10 will be nice. And new body. And repeat again the process. Click here, create sketch. And we will use the circle tools one more time and create another sketch with another type of value. I will work with 12 just here. finish the sketch, and click here, press E, create an extrusion. And I think if I put a value of 6, yeah, I think it will be nice. Maybe I can increase with 8. Yeah, I will put a value of 6 and I will create a new body just like that. So now something that I'm going to do is to create another sketch, create a sketch, and I will work on this work plane. And on this work plane, I will just define a point and I will create a base of line. So I can start here, but I'm going to create voluntary offset. I'm going to show you why, because after I will show you a features. And I can create an element with a value of, here we have 20, with just here 14, yes, with 12. After that, I can press escape. I have this line, finish the sketch, and click on this line, or I will do this after, create, pipe, click here, and I will create a pipe. I will increase a little bit the value. Here I have the hollow features, I don't want that. And here, as you can see, you can have hollow features, but yeah, it's not what I want to do. So I'm going to remove the hollow. I think it's better for what I want to do. And I will extend with value here. We have 4. Let's just work with 3.5. So it's okay for that. After I will, I think 3.5 is a little too much. I will reduce a little bit. Yes, 2.8. And I will just create a new body. After I will use interesting features, so modify, and just select replace face. You can click directly on this face, target face, this one, and you can just link the face together. After I will click here, extrude again. I will extrude with, for example, I have 2 millimeters, and here you can enter a tap taper angles. So if I tap, for example, 20, I will obtain this render. And I can also extend with just 2 millimeters, and take a glance, 20 degrees. Yes, I think it's nice. Maybe it's a little too much. I will just apply 12, and I will click here, extrude again with 2 millimeters. And I will click on new body. Not on new body, I will click on join. It's better. If I take a glance about my body, so we have this element. This element, I will use modify fillet. We'll apply a first fillet on this area, 0.40. Then modify fillet. We'll apply a fillet here. And I will apply a value of, I think, yeah, I think I can apply a value of 12 and modify fillet again. And I will click on this edge. And as you can see, you can do something like that. And I can enter, increase the value. Let's just step 80 and just validate. So I will repeat this element around this area. And for this, I can use create patterns, circular patterns. I will click on this element. Going to show you again, you click on create patterns, rectangular patterns, you can click here, and you need to select the axis. The axis will be on this area. So select axis, I can just click here. Something is wrong. Something is wrong. Create patterns. Yes, it's circular patterns that we need to use. So I can just click here. Because if you use rectangular pattern, it's not this. So you need to use a circular pattern. Yes, definitely it's better. So I can come back, create, and select patterns. Yes, circular patterns. And I can click on this object, axis. And now it's going to work properly. I can click here and I can repeat the process. I can define a number. Here, just 2. If I want to create more, I can do something with 4. So after that, it depends what we want to do. Let's just apply 4 and just validate just here. To continue with this work, we just need to finish with different fillets. So something that I'm going to do is to use my fillet tools, and we are going to make some transformation. So first I will click on this face and I will apply some fillet. Maybe let's try with a value of 1 millimeter. Perfect. Then I will use a fillet tools, click on this face, and it is same. I can work with a value of 1 millimeter. Just like this, and I will validate. So after, I need to link the different elements. So for example, I can click on combine, and I will combine this element with this element, just like this. And yes, I'm going to come back, not combine this element. I'm just going to click here, fillet, and I will apply a small fillet here. So no need to apply too much. I can apply 0.4, for example. Let's just check. Yeah, I think it's nice. I will repeat fillet. Just click here and I will tape 0.4 also. And yes, I can validate. I will click here and fillet. And I will apply also the value of 0.4. So that's okay for that. After, I need to link, combine. I need to combine this one, and validate. After that, I will apply some fillet. I will click here, fillet, go on this area. And as you can see, we can apply a fillet just like this. But just before to do this, I will apply my fillet more on this face first, so I can increase the value, at least a value of, yes, 1. Validate. And after, I will repeat the process with fillet. I will click here. And I will drag and move. And so what value I can enter? It depends about what we want to do. Maybe I can try with 20. Maybe it's too much. Let's try with 16, just like this. And validate. And I will work with this one, fillet. And it is same, I can drag and move. As you can see, not too much, but about the values that we can enter, I think 16 can be great also. And I can just tap 16 again, and I will obtain this render. So after, we can make something more complex, but it's just to show you some basics about what you can do if you want to create a type. Here, it's just for the 3D modeling. It means we don't have here a hole on this area. But it's just for 3D modeling. And for this reason, we can work like this. So it's okay for that. You can take a glance. We have different bodies on this area, as you can see. So we have this one. We can link some bodies if we need, or we can just stay like this. I'm going to go on this area, deactivate my layout grid. And at the same time, I will deactivate here my origins. So it's okay for that. We are going to stop here for this video. I'm just going to save my work because I forgot to save on this area. So I will go just here. Maybe I can change for type, or I will just tap project just here. And I will say in my default project, just save my work. So we are going to stop here with this creation. We're going to stop here for this video. If you like this video, you can subscribe to this YouTube channel. A lot of content, CAD content, 3D modeling content, graphic content. First link on the description, you will see the complete course Fusion 360. So if you want to perfectly master this version of Fusion 360, step by step with a course structure, everything is on the first link on the description. A lot of hours, a lot of session. You will see the models, the session of the course, what you will be able to learn. We will see all the different features in detail, solid, surface, mesh, plastic, and all these different features, all the tools are explained with different concrete examples. And at the end of the course, also different training like this, to create different parts and to create objects. And for the next video on these channels, see you. Ciao, ciao.